If you're new to Smart Connect, here's a little setup guide. You know, you have to enter your email and connection key, or else you have to set up your own, tunnel service. That's like, for a general audience, that's like a super advanced type of thing. You know, like if you haven't run a server before, you're not going to set one up on your own. You know, there are some like hacks where you can like use. I was hoping this user of Smart Connect would share how they did it, but somebody mentioned they did it with Cloudflare. You know, there was like maybe some sort of service in Cloudflare that acts as a tunnel, so they were able to configure that to work with Smart Connect. So you can download the Smart Connect software for free and just make it work with your desktop, without supporting the project or anything like that. Okay, so I just signed in. We have to create a new smart environment. We're going to call this Island Life. The folder is going to point at the same folder as the Obsidian Vault. And I named the, so you see Island Life, this name is the same as the name of the vault, Island Life. And the reason for that is it's currently required for, what you can consider like a deep integration with Obsidian. The Obsidian integration is actually something that, like, I think can be improved a lot in the software, so... we'll turn that on. It's an Obsidian vault. There's some things I want to try with the Obsidian integration, but it's, so far, even as experienced as I am with the Obsidian plugins, it was like kind of hard for me to figure out if, some certain Obsidian, features are available for me to improve that integration. But, what we're looking at here is Obsidian. My Obsidian vault is now configured in Smart Connect. You can see we got these entities embedded. We're embedding blocks. Now, what we got to do is we got to go to the Notes 2 Experimental GPT. Let's stop working with the terminal, and we can say, read my open notes. And this is where the Obsidian integration comes in. So, what we're doing here is what do we got? So we got an error, get current notes. There's a possibility that's because we just connected the things. So I just hit Control R in Smart Connect to refresh. Let's see if it works the second time here. Not connected. Okay, so this is what's happening. We need to have smart connections over here. Number one, we should update it. So check for updates. Update smart connections. Okay, I think we should be good to go because Smart Connect and Smart Connections actually share the same configuration for the most part. There's a few things that are Obsidian specific and a few things that are Smart Connect specific, but anything that configures your smart environment should be shared by both pieces of software. Okay. Let's get back to ChatGPT. Let's retry this again. Read my open notes. Not connected to the HTTP Obsidian server. Why is that? So, doing a little bit of live debugging here. This is like really poor user experience, and I apologize. This is like all very much a work in progress. I appreciate everybody who, still supports the project in spite of this being, sometimes a little tough to work with. Okay, so this time I had Smart Connect running. I refreshed Obsidian. And just to confirm, before we look at another failure, we should see like a HTTP. Okay, so Island Life, that is correct. Okay, so it took a little while, but we've got this app connector initialized. That should be what was missing prior. But good to know. I guess like I'm just always working on this thing and refreshing things. So I guess like I never really noticed how like unlikely that is to just work on the first try. Now I'm a little more confused because it's saying no open notes when we do have this open home note. Okay, like maybe let's just like try again. Let's like stop that. Read my open notes. It like really doesn't like it's not even hitting this Smart Connect instance. Like I'm pretty sure that I turned off my other computer, but that would explain it if it's like go into my other computer for some reason. Let's see here. Yeah, it seems pretty off. I guess like it's possible somebody figured out my test key, but let's check this other computer. This computer is like definitely off. Yeah, that's like really frustrating. And now I gotta turn this computer off again just to, maybe it won't like load in the background if I don't sign in. Okay. Let's just say like get my notes. I mean, I'm just looking to see if we even okay, like so this time we got a request and a response. Okay. Like there we go. Here's the content. Okay, now let's try this next part. Update, if only I could spell. Update, what? I think it's because I'm not used to typing on this little itty bitty laptop keyboard. Update the note by following the the content in the note as instructions. Okay. Presumably, ChatGPT is writing the updated note right now, and it'll send it to Smart Connect, and Smart Connect will update it right in Obsidian. But, you know, so we're still starting action. When you see that, you know, if you're writing a note, you can imagine it's, you know, just writing the thing. And this is what we got. There we go. You know, so if you're using Smart Connect, you get read and write capabilities. Unfortunately, the ChatGPT app isn't there yet. You know, I was hoping it would be. This, you know, the reading writing, you know, part of the software is actually like an incredibly challenging piece of code. You know, you can see the comments on GitHub. I mean, there's a lot of issues with what's currently there, but you know, as you can see, you know, even with the issues, you know, we're still creating notes in Obsidian. You know, we can, you know, I guess I wish these were links, but they're not. You know, let's just, you know, stop this here for now. Thanks for watching. That was testing out ChatGPT's new, you know, desktop interactive feature, which I imagine is their response to Anthropic's use computer, you know, feature. And, you know, now that we know, you know, ChatGPT is currently limited to just reading, you know, something on the screen from a select number of programs. And, you know, unfortunately, Obsidian's not included, you know, in that list. You know, but if you want to use Obsidian with ChatGPT, you can get Smart Connect, connect your Obsidian, you know, ask it to read your notes, ask it to, you know, create a note as we just did here. And yeah, thanks for watching.